Hello students, welcome to Marine Engineering Tutorials. I am Atul Kumar Gupta and back with a new tutorial. We are presently studying marine boilers. Today we have 11th lecture and the topic is economizers and air heaters. Economizers and air heaters are waste heat recovery units used on steamship boilers for improving their efficiency. Economizers are feed water heaters which are commonly used on large water tube boilers, but they are rarely found on motor vessels. Although forced circulation exhaust gas boiler used on motor vessels is also called as economizers and they have similar construction. Following slide discusses the construction and operation of economizer. This sketch shows the construction and operation of an economizer. Let us see the components of economizer and the flow of feed water and flue gases through it. We have the feed water inlet header. Here we have feed water from outlet header. This is the tube plate to which these coils are attached. We have the multiple loop tube element. We have the expansion ring which facilitates the expansion of the multi-loop tube element. The anchor collar is on the other side of the tube plate which holds the multi-loop tube element in place. We have the two foot blowers for keeping the surfaces clean. We have mild steel fins in the lower part of the economizer. And we have galvanized iron fins in the upper part of the economizer where water temperature is low. We have the double casing, so the ends are not heated. We have the support beam on which the economizer is mounted. And we have gases from the boiler uptake coming from the bottom and they leap from the top to the funnel. It consists of solid forged mild steel inlet and outlet headers to which multi-loop tube elements are attached by expansion and bell mouthing or welding through stub tubes. Solid drawn mild steel tubes with MS fins are used for temperature above 138 degrees centigrade, whereas GI fins are used below this temperature in order to protect plain tubes from corrosive attack. Tubes are supported by tube plates and are equipped with soot blowing arrangement to maintain clean tube surface for high efficiency and to prevent the uptake fire. Multi-loop tube element are fixed on one side with the anchor collar, whereas other end is equipped with expansion ring which provides necessary expansion allowance. Inlet header is equipped with a vent to release air and outlet header with a drain to empty out the economizer. So this is a brief description of economizer. This sketch shows a tubular air heater equipped on the earlier scotch boilers which was arranged vertically in the flue gas outlet. Smoke tube boilers are not used on steamships nowadays and those equipped on the motor vessels are auxiliary boilers which do not have air heaters. Air after passing around the smoke tubes enters the air resistor through plenum, whereas flue gas after hitting the air leaves through the funnel, which we can see in the sketch. Combustion air from FD fan around the tubes takes away the heat from the flue gases which are passing in the tubes, and the exhaust gases coming out from the air heater, they leave the boiler and go to the funnel. This sketch shows an air heater used on large capacity water tube boilers. Let's see the components of air heater and the flow of flue gases and combustion air through the heater. So first of all, we have tube plate to which the horizontal tubes are attached. Then we have the expansion joint which provides the linear expansion of the air heater. This is the support beam which is helping to secure the air heater in place. We have a bypass damper which can allow the flow of air bypassing the air heater when the load on the boiler is low. We have the soot blowers which are used for keeping the surfaces clean. This is the soot blower support. We have flue gas inlet from the bottom and it leaves from the top. Similarly, we have combustion air entering from the top, and if required, we can bypass it, as shown here in the bypass passage, and finally it leaves into the boiler to the burners. This sketch shows a regenerative air heater operating on an entirely different principle and is used on modern water tube boilers. This heater consists of a drum rotating very slowly between 2 to 4 RPM in a cylindrical casing. The drum is connected with passages for inlet and outlet of air and the flue gases as shown in the diagram. So we can see this is known as Jungstrom air heater, and this is the driving motor which is shown, which drives the rotor, and on either side of the center line we have gas and air passages as we can see on the right side. This is the combustion air from FD fan, and it goes to the burners. Similarly, the flue gas from the boiler passes to the heater, and after heating the incoming combustion air, it leaves the air heater and passes to the funnel. Following slide shows the drum internal arrangement. The drum consists of closed pitch thin plates which provide large surface area for heat exchange to take place. The plates absorb heat while passing through the flue gas stream and give up this heat when it moves to the combustion air passage. Fine clearance between the stationary and the moving parts limit the mixing of two fluids. So we can see the nomenclature. First of all, we have the driving motor rotating this rotor through reduction gearing at a very low RPM. Then it is shown that very close pitched plates are fitted in this rotor, which are in segments. Combustion air from the FD fan comes from the right side of the rotor passage and it goes to the burner. On the other hand, the flue gas, which is entering from the bottom on the left side, it passes up to the funnel. So when the rotor gets heated through the passing in the flue gas passage, it gives its heat to the air, and thus the air gets heated and goes to the burner. This sketch shows an air heater in which blood steam from the turbine is used to heat up the combustion air. First of all, we can see the parts and the flow of fluids through the air heater. So we have steam inlet header on one side, and on the side of it we have condensate header. These are arranged in sections so that if there is a trouble with one of the section, it can be isolated. This has fin U-tubes. These tubes are made of cupronickel and are having copper fins, and these are expanded into the steel, steam and condensate header, which is placed side by side. This is the steam inlet, and from the bottom we have condensate drain. The air is entering across the tubes, and from the other end is passing to the burners. The steam heating coils are built up in sections so that they can be isolated if the leakage occurs. These air heaters are sometimes equipped with a bypass arrangement. This completes the study of economizers and air heaters. This book is written by me and covers all the topics as per Indian Maritime University syllabus. It clarifies the concepts with simple illustrations. This book also provides answers to all the questions which have appeared in the examination conducted by Indian Maritime University. This book can help the students in preparing for exam and also to work on the ship's boiler safely. Hope that you have liked the lecture. You can write your feedback in the comment box. If you have liked the tutorial, you may share it with your friends. You may subscribe to the channel for getting notification about the new tutorials. I'll be back with a new lecture shortly. Thanks for watching till the end.